Good afternoon, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for your coming here. My name is Mokrtić. My short name is Niko. I am a PhD student at the ISA Universidade de Lisboa at the Biology of Department. My supervisor is Professor Manuel Manfredo Ferreira, and I am here to present to you about my Armenian heritage, about my culture of my country, and my background and my future goals in the Portugal. Thank you for coming, and I hope you will enjoy all this presentation. Thank you. This is the map of my country. It's Armenia. It's located in South Caucasus. It's a region of Eurasia. But our neighbors from the south is Georgia, Azerbaijan, Iran, and Turkey. Capital of my country is Yerevan. We have no nothing ocean, nothing sea. We have only small Lake Sevan, it's like our, for us, it's sea. We are a country for mountains because we have an old history. We are the most ancient countries of the Europe, and we are the first Christian country in the Europe. Republic of Armenia. This is our Transkei flag, and this is the map of my country. It's divided in 14 regions. The region, the very big region is Yerevan, the capital of Armenia, population 3 million, but only not 3 million in our country, also 7 million. It's divided all the countries in Europe. The big population Armenian community in USA, in French, in Moscow. In Portugal, we have only like 1,000 people, Armenian people here, but like we are starting to growing, like, to colonize our roots here, because this is our small country. It's including, in my country, it's semi-presidential republic, government type. We call it Artsakh. It's a new name. The old name is Nagorno-Karabakh. The population is very small, like the population is Braga or Viana de Castelo. 1,500 people. Official language Armenian is also the Christian apostolic currency. Our currency is Armenian dirham. And here I want to also to present some new video about my two countries, starting from geolocation, new infrastructure, innovation, agri-food sector, and everything.
Why is Armenia the best place for the VEON Leadership Meeting? The geographical location of Armenia on the cusp of Eastern and Western civilizations makes it easily accessible for everyone. Obtaining an Armenian visa is a quick and hassle-free procedure, while for a number of countries, it's not required whatsoever. Due to its subtropical climate, one can enjoy sunshine in all seasons, which makes Armenia an all-year-round touristic destination, with majestic landscapes of snowy mountains, freshwater lakes, and sunny valleys. The abundance of spacious, sophisticated hotel complexes and high-profile, well-equipped facilities makes Armenia a great venue for world-class meetings. Multifaceted, multicultural, sunny, and hospitable Armenia is thus a place where you can combine business with pleasure. Welcome to Armenia.
One of the most and very cultural heritages in my country. It is including since 2014 in the Heritage European in the UNESCO Foundation, and now the some Italian groups working on the on this temple to recover it, because after the earthquake in 301, after the Christian, some earthquake and nothing after that, no group from the European countries come and don't recover this, because it's very unique, very historical places, and they promise us they will do it and recover it, because it's one of the most Armenian heritages in the UNESCO. This is Armenian Echmiadzin Cathedral Monastery, and this is our first monastery. It's, and also this is cross stones. The age of this, between these cross stones, is 4,000 years old. We have only some of this quality, like only 10 values in my country. Because this, you can't take it, you can't touch it, because it, the age is very ancient. And sometimes they sound swearing, blaking when you want to touch it. And I want to also to present you some videos about my monastery, churches, and everything. Sorry, but time is not enough to speak about this, because this is very big problem, and this problem is coming from the deep of the century, from the first war, and this time I will speak with another presentation, maybe next year. And I want to show my starting from my specialization times, from the Armenian fruits. One of the most beautiful and sweet in the Europe, and the traditional fruits, pomegranate, apricot, and the grape. From this apricot, it's make Armenian musical instrument. We call it duduk. It's traditional instrument. It is included in the European instrument in the UNESCO. Who see the gladiator films? At that time, an Armenian duduk voice, it is playing in the gladiator. It is considered magic Armenian duduk and blending Armenian heritage. Armenian cuisine. This part for lovely for me. I like this tolma from the for your right side. From the left side, we call it vegetable tolma, because for the making process we use greenhouses, pepper, cabbage, tomato, baggage, everything. We only cut it the quantity of the vegetable and put it inside the rice, meat, something dry fruit, and we are waiting for the eating. We eating with the lavash. It's our Armenian traditional bread. It's also considered Armenian heritage and included in the UNESCO cultural heritage. This is the process and ingredients how you can make a tolma for the Happy New Year, because every Armenian family who are living in Armenia or the borderline from Armenia, every time they make a tolma. Tolma is usually red when you use rice, grape leaf and cabbage leaves, everything. And I want to show you the process of the making of the Armenian lavash, how we can make it. Because you have never seen something like this, only our country has the process of making. This is Armenian Ararat Akhmar and Adborni brandy From this part is Ararat. Its name coming from the Ararat brandy company. We have Ararat Mountain, Ararat Hair Lane, Ararat brandy, everything. It's called the Ararat. And I want to now invite you to drink a little of these beautiful drinks with the Armenian lavash or the bread I was going to bring in Spain, because it's very special for me to invite you and drink a little of the Ararat and juice with Armenian lavash. Please come on the tables and for the tasting, Armenian, yes.
Don't want to go to provide. Thank you.
beautiful video how the testing we make the Minyan brandy, how we collect from the garden grape and the final the process starting from fermentation and the package about all the processes. Also one additional information, this Armenian brandy is translation from English to Armenian, Armenian cognac, but the European Union gives also 25 years in the Europe to use Armenian cognac. After the 25 years, we must to change the cognac name and on the bottles to write every time the Armenian brandy. Only 25 years you have time to bottle it, after that you have no chances. This is my for the Happy New Year collection. And this is Armenian pomegranate and Karas wines. I like pomegranate because it's like the inspiration. Like if you open the bottle of the Armenian wine made from the pomegranate, like you cut it like a fresh pomegranate. And also this Karas is a famous Armenian wine. It has three types of the wine: dry, semi-sweet, semi-dry, and also the first shop last year it opened in the Argentina. Next year it will be in the European Union, but I hope it will be in Portugal. This is for the new technologies about the Armenian brandy manufacturing, starting from the export, import, hectoliters, and everything. Now I want to invite you to test Armenian bread, lavash, and little Armenian pasturma, we call it pasturma, it's made from the Armenian beef. And 5 minutes break time, after that we will continue. Ladies and gentlemen, I want also to present you some new video about the Armenian roots and the usual life of the Armenian village man. The difference between the city man and the village man. In the sphere of agriculture sector. This is our rector from 1998, from rector of Arnaut. We have seven faculties. I'm a graduate from Faculty of Agronomy. We have a different scientific and problematic laboratories. The Center of Viticulture, Fruit Growing and Winemaking, this laboratory and scientific research center are playing crucial role of the Armenian winemaking sector and economy. They are doing every time to find out the cases of soil degradation, identify measures to combat soil degradation, taking into account global climate changes, to develop new soil cultivation technologies and more efficient irrigation methods. Center of Agro-Biotechnology, it's a new center opened in 2020 in the scope of Erasmus+. And there are doing virus-free seed potato production by tissue culture features, development of effective technology for virus-free seeding, micro reproduction, ex situ and in vitro plant conservation and in vitro selection. This is the usual work for the laboratory workers. And center of viticulture for growing and winemaking. I want to little speak about this region, this center work. They are doing a study of the European red varieties and determination of their sustainability for the wine and Armenian brandy production. Research works on the development of various wine types production technologies, choosing the best oak species to be used in the brandy production. To take only the one of the big, one of the moist European grapes who can grow in the Armenian conditions of here. This is our new nursery. It is opened in 2012. We had the first harvest, little at 1,000 square meters. Another laboratory of genophon and selection of plants, study of sort varieties, enrichment of seed bank, creation of electronics databases, laboratory seed collection. They are collecting very useful seeds from India wheat, barley, everything, or maybe the something will be after like 25 years old and we have not seeds. To protect all the foods, fruits from GMO, like genetic modified organisms. This is India wheat, the between is summer wheat, and lab of agriculture and food genetics and biotechnology. It's a new laboratory opened in 2012. They have equipment like study of electrophoresis system, interferon system, proteins and DNA variation, study of polymorph proteins and another processes, killing process. This is the time when we are opening our president, our head of the chair, from this side, our Ministry of Education and Science. I'm doing my master's degree with my professor, and we are preparing Elektra Agarov girl. And nice. I'm in the University of Saloniki in the Greece. I'm cutting the oregano leaves to receive something liquid and to combine the DNA molecules. And here I'm also, I don't know what I'm doing, but it's very good, I think. Here I'm writing the speedometer and the amplitude of the electric power T for the go and coming. And this is the gel after the electroagarose and polyacrylic amine gel. We are working on the tomato. After drink much more grease brandy, grease wine, it's okay. And here, my bachelor degree, my background is comparative study of growth and yield of Aiwazans, Bartarud and Mashal sorts. It's a very famous Armenian grape, and the French Pernod Ricard brandy company use Mashal variety in the French. And also we have in my country branch of the Pernod Ricard Armenia. Trial economic conditions of the Armenian National Agrarian University. My master's degree, the theme of the thesis, comparative characteristic of several varieties of tomato with genetic markers in the conditions of the greenhouses. Master's degree in research project on the School of Agriculture of the Aristotle University of Thessaloniki. And after that, I was going to service in army 2 years. I lose 2 very beautiful years. I don't know why, but and after that, like, I come back to PhD research in the University of Minho, Portuguese viticulture and brandy production in the scope of Erasmus Plus. I was going to all the viticultural regions in the Portugal, starting from Ponta de Lima, across Valdebes, Sogrape, Ponta de Lima, Ban Algar, Fatima, everything. Not only the Porto Alegre. I will speak about this separately. This is now my home university, Institute Superior Agronomia. It's like for me very good universities. And my schedule graphic made from my supervisor. And I have 5 subjects, every subject is 6 ECTS. For me, the best, everything is okay, but I think it's written in Portuguese. I think you should have too much when I explain. This is my PhD research project, The Influence of Consumer Segmentation on Initial Wine Leaking. It's starting from the 5 points. The first is tester selection, tester segmentation, determination of flavor and taste sensitivities, influence of wine modulation on emotional responses, food pairing to increase wine preference. In the end of the work, we want to provide like the Jewish lens, the book for the commercial valuation of particular niche wine among consumers with effective preferences. My supervisor is Professor Manuel Malfetto Fraser. I am very glad that he's my professor because he helps me in every wine, starting from translation to Portuguese to English, in every kind of lesson. And we are working here. I kidnapped this medical course from the professors. It's a little short for me, and we are working on the process. And he sent me to go to bring some apples in for the eating. I don't know why. And this is the piano songer.
Can we see it?
Yes, but his name is Yana Khachaturian. She's one of the most Armenian piano songers in my country. And you are always welcome to invite my presentation and listen your beautiful voice from made for your beautiful fingers.
and she's a pianist.
Yes.
A pianist.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. And I want to also to say my congratulations to professors and professor wife because today is her day, and I wish you everything in your working and personal life. The new year starting for you very good, starting much more working hugeness and everything financial in your